सुनिए सदगुरु डिस्कोर्सेस कारवा 2.0 पर।
The world of mythology is full of stories. There are stories of different types. There are stories of instances. There are stories of occasions. There are stories of festivals. There are stories of relationships and so on. Today I will be telling you some of these interesting stories from across the world. All of us have heard about the great Trojan War from Greek mythology. But let us understand what really triggered off that huge war, where it is said that the gods and the entire Greece participated in this massive war. The crux of all this, of course, is Helen of Troy. All of us have read or even heard or even seen on celluloid the Greek romance of Helen and Paris. So what is it that has made this romance so well known that generations later people recount it again and again? Many of us know about the romance which led to the war, but not many know as to what led to the romance in the first place. So let's start at the very beginning with the root cause of romance, which led to the massive war in which gods sided with mortals, something quite unheard of. It all started in the heavens with the episode better known as the Judgment of Paris. Eris was an evil goddess of discord, conflict, fights. And due to her nature, she was not invited to the heavenly gatherings. During one such gathering, she was the lone goddess who was not invited. She decided to avenge the insult by creating trouble, and trouble she did. She threw in the banquet hall a golden apple on which was written, "For the fairest." Quite predictably, all the goddesses laid claim on it. But eventually, it narrowed down to three of them: Hera, Athena, and Aphrodite. They asked Zeus, the king of gods, to arbitrate. But then better sense prevailed, and he suggested that they go to Mount Ida and meet Prince Paris, who was supposed to be a very good judge of beauty, and let them decide. Before we move further, let's understand something about Paris. Paris, though a son of the king, was guarding the sheep, as his father was told that he would be responsible for the destruction of his country. The king had thus sent him away to the mountains to keep him away from the country, lest the prophecy come true. The three goddesses reached Mount Ida and asked Paris to arbitrate on the celestial problem. Paris was amazed at the job and could not believe his luck. However, his judgment did not rest on the actual beauty of the goddesses, but on the bribes that each offered to him. Hera promised to make him the lord of Europe and Asia. Athena offered him victory of the Trojans against the Greeks, leading to the ruin of Greece. Aphrodite offered him the love of the fairest of all mortals, which was none other than Helen. Paris offered the golden apple to Aphrodite, much to the disappointment of the others. It is this judgment due to which the great Trojan War was fought. Helen's beauty was a subject of heavens and was the mortal daughter of Zeus and Leda. Every prince in Greece wanted to marry her, and when all had assembled to ask for her hand, it was a gathering of who's who amongst the rich and the powerful. Helen's father, or rather, the husband of her mother, was scared to choose one, lest he offended the rest and invite the collective wrath of the mighty. He then extracted an oath from all, that all of them would stand by Helen's husband, whoever he be, and if he faced any problem, then all would unite with the husband and fight the enemy. Each agreed, as each wanted to be the husband. Helen's father then selected Menelaus and also made him the king of Sparta. Aphrodite, having won her title of the fairest, took Paris straight to Sparta, where he was received by Menelaus and Helen. To cut short the story, before anybody realized, love had blossomed and Helen eloped with Paris. When Menelaus came to know about it, he called on all the chiefs of Greece and sought their help to get Helen back. They all responded as they were bound by the oath. The war between the Greeks and the Trojans was a war of the epics. Heroes were made and killed. gods sided with the central characters during the war. Gods like Zeus, Achilles, Athena, Hera, Apollo, etc. all took sides. Heroes like Odysseus, Menelaus, Hector were made, and some died heroic deaths. The Trojans were destroyed. I will spare the details of the heroism of the bloody war, as our subject is still love. And what's better love story than the one which has a happy ending? Helen goes back to Menelaus, and the initial prophecy was proven that Paris would bring destruction to his country. Needless to say that the gods were behind the mortal destruction, all for vanity of three goddesses, which is such a human emotion. If you like these stories and you want to hear more of them, please share, like and subscribe to our channel Saregama Music.
Ek haseena thi, ek divana tha, kya umar, kya sama, kya zamana.
Thank you.